So last week we had gone through these cards and we had extracted some information. For instance, we had tried to find out what was the average marks, or we had tried to find out what was the average marks among the girls and the boys. So what do you suggest we do now?
We could try something slightly different. How about trying to find out which student is has got the best marks, best total marks?
Oh, so for that, of course, we have to go through all the cards, but then how do we keep track of the best marks?
As we go along, I guess we just keep aside the card that is the highest, maybe the
most. Yeah, so we can just keep remembering who has the highest card marks among the cards we have seen and just check against that. So 240 is, as far as we know, the highest because we haven't seen anything.
Correct.
So we'll keep it aside separately.
So we are keeping on this side, on the right side, the card that we have seen, which has the highest total marks.
Yes. And now we'll look at the next card. It's 196. And since 196 is not the highest so far, we can move it aside. We don't need to look at it again.
Okay. So that side, we're keeping the cards which we're discarding.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And now we come to 252. But since 252 is bigger than the one that we had before, this becomes the new highest.
So we replace this with 252. Okay.
Now we see 210. So 210 is smaller. So we move it aside. 276 is higher.
Greater.
So we take
276
and replace it.
Yeah. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Now 181 is smaller. 240 is smaller. 173 is smaller. 247 is smaller.
Mm-hmm.
204 is smaller.
Mm-hmm.
187 is smaller. 224 is smaller. I wonder if 276 is
might be the best. Yeah. Deepika. Mm-hmm.
244 is smaller. 221, 261, 254, 219, 227, 209, 174, 188. We are running out of cards.
Yeah,
198.
Yeah. So 276. Deepika is looking good.
210, 250 close.
Mm-hmm.
252. 189, 224, 281. So 281 is bigger than 276.
So now Rahul replaces Deepika as the topper right now. 281.
227. And finally 216.
So we have the highest scorer.
So we have gone through all the cards and we have effectively kept aside the maximum one that we have seen.
So 281 is the highest.
281 is the maximum.
So is there another way to do this? I mean, without taking out this maximum card and keeping it on the side, is there a way?
Yeah, so I think we are basically remembering something. So what we need to do is, like we did last time, maybe just use a variable, like we were keeping the count and the sum and we keep updating it. It's only slightly different. Instead of updating the count by adding something or adding to the sum, we are replacing, right? We take the maximum, which we have seen so far, we remember that. And when we see a new number bigger than that, we replace it by that. So we are comparing with what we have.
Want to try that?
And then we do. So let's try that.
Okay. So let me.
So we will write
a
name. So let us call it Max. So Max is the number that quantity we want to keep track of.
Max, all right.
Right? Mm-hmm.
Max, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So then initially
it is has to be set to some value, right? What do we set it to?
So we don't know. So the way we did it was we just set it to the first card that we saw, right? So let's just do that. So
why don't we set it
to
something?
Okay, now we know it's marks, so we know that
it can't be below zero.
So
zero is the absolute minimum.
So let's say zero.
Zero, okay. Let's set it to zero. Okay. So we have initialized. So this is a variable max,
yeah,
which we have initialized to zero, and we are starting the iterator now.
Yes.
So as usual in the iterator we will take one card at a time,
okay,
and move it to a different pile.
Okay.
Right. So we are taking the first card, total is 174.
Okay.
So 174 is greater than 0.
Yeah. So we will replace this by
174.
Okay.
Next we are seeing the second card, 209.
Which is also bigger.
209 is bigger than 174.
Yeah.
So we replace 174 by 209.
Yes.
Now the third card has 227 on it. 227 is bigger than 209.
So this becomes now 227.
227. Now we have 219.
Which is smaller than.
Smaller than 227. So what do?
We just pass it up without doing any update.
So this is a very interesting thing, right? Because it looks like we are filtering the cards.
Yes.
Because these cards we did something. We did an update.
Hmm.
Like we did last time, we added everything. Here we added some of only the boys, for example, or something like that. Or count of only the boys.
Correct.
Here we are, when we looked at 227, we did an update, but when we saw 219,
we are not making.
We are not making an update.
Correct.
So this is like a filtering in a sense, but
yeah, but the condition that we are checking is not. See, in the filtering case, we were checking the same condition right through, whether it's a boy, whether it's a girl. Here we are checking a condition which is changing. We are checking against a number we have keeping
on changing.
Yeah, so that's.
So we are comparing with a variable.
Yes.
Rather than comparing with a constant.
Yes.
So that's how it's different, right? So 219 we have looked at. 254
So this is a new one, which
is
we
bigger. Yeah. So we update it. 261 is also bigger. So we update it. 221 is smaller.
So we
skip it. 281, which we have already seen, is bigger. 244
is smaller.
224 is smaller. 187 is smaller. 204 is smaller. 247 is smaller. 173 is smaller. We remember from the last iteration that
281 is actually the biggest.
So 181. So I guess we will just go through all the cards. 252, 210, 240, 196, 216, 227, 276. This was the, if you remember last time, was the card that had the high marks for some time. 224, 189, 252, 250, 210, 198, and 180. So we have gone through all the cards.
So in the end,
so the first pile is empty. Yeah. The second pile has all the cards in it.
And in the end, we know that the max is 281.
So this is again an example of an iterator.
Yes.
It's an iterator with a filter in it.
Yes.
Except that the filter is comparing the variable with the value on the card, and then the variable's value is being updated in case the variable value is less than the value on the card.
Correct.
So the variable keeps track of the latest. Of the highest marks we have seen so far. And by that, when we have seen all the cards, it therefore has the value of the highest marks.
Very good.